Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I want to talk about some different types of ways that we can look at data. One is a scatter plot, and that's a plot of paired quantitative data. And scatter plots are a useful way to compare two sets of data. And when you're looking at that, you could have a positive correlation where you can see that the plotted points make a line going up, or they might make a sort of line going down. Or you could have no correlation, which means they don't form a line at all. So let's say that in this case, we're talking about the horizontal axis is the amount of time you spend studying, and the vertical axis is your grade. Well, if you don't study very much, your grade isn't very high. But if you study a lot, your grade is higher. That's a positive correlation, right? You do more of one thing, brings up more of something else. So that'd be a positive correlation. And typically when we plot points, they don't make a perfect line, but they make a relative, you can start to say it looks like there is a line being formed there, right? Negative correlation has to do with one thing going up makes something else go down. Let's say that this is your driving ability on the x-axis and the amount of alcohol that you've consumed here. So if you haven't consumed very much alcohol, then, or which way would it go? The opposite way. Your driving ability is on the vertical, and how much alcohol you've consumed is here. So if you haven't consumed very much alcohol, your driving ability is good. And as you consume more and more alcohol, your driving ability goes down. That's a negative correlation. Consume one thing going up causes the other to go down. That's negative. And then the last one is if there's no correlation at all. So you just see these points all over the place and you can't really see anything. Maybe the number of jobs you've had in your life compared to the number of cousins that you have. And it's like there's no relationship. Who knows, you know? So that could be something that we try, but it doesn't look like there's any relationship or no correlation there. A dot plot is a statistical chart consisting of data points plotted on a fairly simple scale, typically using filled in circles or little dots called dots for a dot plot. In the dot plot below, there were 3 months when one book was read. So it's looking at number of books read per month. So when there was one book read, there were 3 different months that did that. And then another example, in 2 months, there was 2 different times they read 8 books in the month. So that's just all that means. If the same value comes up again, you just stack it so that you can say like, wow, it looks like the highest stacks where they either read 7 or 9 books, right? Those are the months that occurred most frequently. So a dot plot is just a simple thing like that. And the last one I wanted to talk about is a Pareto chart. And I'm not even sure if you'll be asked to do it, but anyway, it contains both bars and line graph. Individual values are represented in descending order by bars. So you always put the tallest bar to the left and then going down to the right. The cumulative total is represented by the line. This is the percent over here. This is the frequency. So this is a good example. I forgot what website that I found this online somewhere, but it's nice because it shows you this. Critical is 50. And that represents 32.9%. So at 50 on this over here, we are at 32.9 over here. And then the next one is 40. When you're at 40, 40 represents 26.3%. And then you add that together cumulatively with the 32.9 and the 26.3 means that at the end of this, or the middle of this, we are up to 59.2%. And then we go on to say in the next one was 35. You can see it's 35 over here. That represents another 23%. So if we add that on to our last, we're up here at 82%. And when you finish, the line's going to be up to 100%. That's going to add up all the different cumulative totals and get 100 because that makes sense, right? Since in the end, we have 100%. And over here, it shows that. So there's a lot of different things that that graph shows. We don't use them that much, but it's just nice to see what they are. All right, have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.